it's pretty much what we are is determined by genes and environment. So these are the two things. So genes are very important. So there were studies on human populations, and they showed that for an average person, the genes contribute about 25% of, you know, how long we are going to live. But this is for average people. So now when scientists looked at centenarians, or those people that live more than 100 years, so their genes were much more important. So to live that long, you actually have to have a very lucky combination of genes. But for an average person, yeah, genes are important, but of course, healthy lifespan, healthy life habits are also important. Everything we talked about, you know, not eating too much, healthy diet, some exercise. But if you look at, you know, beyond humans, at, you know, animal world, of course, the genes determine that the mouse lives 2 years and like elephant can live 80 years or human can live 100 years. So a lot is determined by genes when we talk about these big differences. There are many researchers studying such people that are exceptionally long-lived, looking at their genes. So there are many genes were found. It's a challenge to actually find those genes that actually matter, because if you compare two different humans, there will be so many small differences in the genes, and then saying, okay, which one allows this person to live so long? And to make it, you know, more complicated, it's not like one gene, but there are combinations of many, many genes, and some combinations are more beneficial than others. So now, when it became so cheap to sequence human DNA, so I think we'll see a lot of progress, but once you sequence, there is so much information, and again, really looking through it and finding what's important and what's not is a challenge. But my group also collaborates with researchers working on centenarians, and we look at some candidate genes that seem to be promising. Well, so the idea is you take the same sort of ethnical population of people, because of course if you compare Japanese to Europeans, there will be so many differences and you won't be able to tell which one is important for lifespan or which one is just important for, you know, facial features that are different. So you have to say, take Japanese population and select families where people live very long and average living families, and then find certain genes that really are more frequently present in long-lived families, but not in average Japanese population. So this way you can come with a list of genes. So then the real test is then to say, take Italian population. So there are also many people that live very long, and then do the same thing and then compare. So which genes are now common between people that live for a long time in Italy and in Japan. And this way you can really narrow down. There are so many genes and so many small, very small differences. So, you know, there is a lot of research going into that direction. But yeah, there are some findings. Of course, first people started by looking at candidate genes. For example, you know, this gene is important for heart health. So let's see if in people that live very long time, this gene, you know, is different. So several things were found like that, but then you may also ask the question, well, maybe, you know, this is not what determines the rate of aging, it just determines how healthy their hearts are. So now people are trying to look at the entire genome to find the genes that really set the pace for aging. Well, it's something I really love. It's the passion of my life, to aging research, and I like to explain to people how important and how fascinating it is, because, you know, more people understand it, so then there will be more support for this work, and, you know, benefits everybody.